Off on another adventure, are we?
Slippery little shrake, aren't you? No spy. The curiosity they teach at Hogwarts will not serve you well.
Revelio.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. Just like a Gryffindor to brave the Forbidden Forest in pursuit of adventure.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin. Or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the Bible. I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is, rather unfortunately, coming back to me. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu. Is that Latin? Or Greek?
Nothing to do now but keep going. The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word. Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. But you've been paying attention to defense against the dark.
Well, get away with that.
Why
stupendous? I won't rest until dead.
Incendio.
No risk those loyalists will report back to Ranrok now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
Revelio.
I wonder how big this place is. These rooms must have something to do with opening this door. I can shoot the symbol, but it doesn't stay lit for long. Impressive. That must be where all this leads.
Revelio.
Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this.
Incendio. Protego.
Stupid one. Stupid one.
Incendio.
Protego.
Incendio. Revelio. Incendio.
I'm not gonna touch that. Ugh.
Potato! Stupid! Revelio.
If I could summon that platform to me, I could likely get on it.
Revelio. Incendio!
Stupid one!
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Accio! Akio.
Untouched chest. JACKDAW wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Revelio. Potato! Stupid! Stupid! Stupid!
Cursed fiends. Another puzzle. Well, if JACKDAW could solve this, so can I.
Revelio. Revelio.
I'm glad Richard JACKDAW left a little something behind for me, but where could he be?
Revelio.
It's a good thing JACKDAW didn't fall down there.
Accio.
Thank you.
That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Accio! Revelio! Incendio!
An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. Skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Incendio!
There it is. The bridge, it's almost complete.
Huh. Accio. Incendio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. More spiders. These can't be what beheaded Richard Jackdaw. Stupefy! Protego! Stupefy! Incendio! Not my fault you're a deadly great spider. Farewell, monster. I can only imagine how the spiders have multiplied since Jackdaw came this way. Revelio. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loop. There's no sign of him. I'll need to look around for the symbol.
Rebellion.
Thank you.
must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages.
Revelio.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room? And the restricted section. Where am I?
Revelio.
Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place?
can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the map chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Revelio.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
Revelio.
What are you up to now?
Incendio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
You need to learn the Pulso, the banishing charm, useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.
Revelio. Brilliant. Revelio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place. Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale?
What can I help you with today? Yes, a wonderful choice. I hope to see you again sometime.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started.
Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it?
Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
Up!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
I think I'm getting the hang of this. This is brilliant.
Good grip. Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we?
This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day!
The old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year.
To make an appearance once in a while.
Made it. Did anyone else see that?
I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Gryffindor like you might be interested in a high-flying adventure?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now.
Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today.
Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead of the gardens, the Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Now that's more like it.
Then,
you sure you're not part Hippogriff?
And Meowlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Best hurry back.
Most lights have already dismissed past.
Better hurry and hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I'm disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky. Revelio.
I've not forgotten about our library venture. How did you fare? If you're keen for some illicit spell practice, meet me outside the Defense Against the Dark Arts classroom. I know a discreet place near there.
Please meet me in the 7th floor corridor as soon as you can. I have an idea for somewhere you can focus on your studies, away from prying eyes and distractions.
Revelio.
Thank you.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Come on in. Healing potions are a speciality here, should you need any.
Hello, Mr. Pippin. You need help with a delivery?
Yes, I do. A capable student such as yourself should have no trouble making the trip to Cambridge. It's just south of Hogwarts.
What do you need delivered?
Fatima Lawang ordered a few invisibility potions. I used to go myself, but lately Fatima has taken to turning every visit into an argument. Constantly complaining about the quality of my stock. But how can I maintain excellence when she orders so often, giving me no time to brew? If you'd take this rather irritating task off my hands, I'd happily allow you to claim the delivery fee from Fatima.
I'd be happy to help with the delivery.
You've no idea how grateful I am, truly. Here are the invisibility potions she requested. Hopefully she won't give you too much trouble. She's a talented potioner in her own right. I dare say I wouldn't mind having a look at her potion recipes one day.
Revelio.
It's like a place right out of a storybook.
Always late, that Pippin.
I'm going straight to that troll, and I'm going to kill you.
Madam Luang, I have a delivery from J. Pippin's potions.
Sent a child to do his work for him, did he? Always cutting corners and taking the easy way out. Did he have you brew them for him as well? Doesn't matter. You could probably do it better than he can anyway.
Here are the potions you requested.
You think it's so simple? I know Pippin is always trying to cheat his customers. Cutting corners to save some galleons for himself at the expense of quality. You'll not be getting a canut out of me until you prove the potion works. Drink it.
Seems simple enough. I'll do it.
I should think so.
Revelio.
It seems to have worked.
Well, I suppose that will do.
If the demand for potions is as high as you say, have you considered being easier to work with? Perhaps combining your recipes and skills?
Ha! Not a chance. That ne'er-do-well had his shop handed to him. The rest of us had to make our own way. I'll not give him the benefit of my hard work and gumption. If he fails on his own, so be it.
You mentioned that more and more customers are trying to stay out of sight. Why?
Well, I can't speak for all of them, but certainly my Ashwinder customers have their reasons. If I were you, I'd forget I heard that.
Very well. I shall let Mr. Pippin know I delivered the potions as requested.
You do that.
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? A fine choice. Exactly what I would have chosen. Thank you for stopping in. I appreciate it.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Hello there. In the market for potions, are we?
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
Nothing to worry about. I handled it.
Glad to hear it. And thank you again for your help.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Pippin.
Likewise. Worth every bit of that delivery fee to have someone capable deal with that witch.
Best of luck with your potions, Mr. Pippin.
Do take care. What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now. What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now. What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you.
Excellent.
Professor Sharp is so intimidating.
How are your assignments coming along?
I completed your assignments, Professor.
Good. You should be ready to learn Depulso. Let's see what you can do. Concentrate. Do not let your mind wander. You've got it now.
If you'd like to practice, and I think you should,
Perhaps best not to go flinging your classmates about the halls. I suggest having a go at the enchanted books here. I'm glad to see that you seem staunchly determined to master your spellcasting.
Accio!
tasks I've given you and then meet me in my classroom to learn Defindo, the severing charm. It's typically used to cut an object, but can be a powerful weapon when needed.